Moses, John the Baptist, Elijah, even more recent preliminary messengers of God like Kurt Cobain, even dating back to Adam, all made in the similitude of Christ? Stay tuned. Welcome to the Word of Life podcast, where we discuss scripture based on scripture, line upon line, precept upon precept, here a little, there a little, feeding the lambs of Christ regardless of the traditions of our fathers and the precepts of man. I ask that you prayerfully consult the Holy Spirit to lead you into all truth. For those who have ears to hear, please let them hear. Hi everybody, thank you for tuning in. In this video, we're going to take another look at Malachi 3:1. And this is a verse in the Bible where we could actually find Kurt Cobain, who was a preliminary messenger for the last days, John the Baptist. If you're not familiar with this topic, I highly recommend looking in the description box below, seeing the playlist and the according videos. But we've been covering this extensively. And here is a slide where we clearly find Kurt Cobain in the Bible. Now, of course, this is a prophecy about John the Baptist. This is a prophecy about Elijah. But another earlier facet of this is indeed about Kurt Cobain. And it's clearly spelled out on this slide. So I want to invite you to screenshot this slide and study it on your own. What I really want to focus on, though, in this video is the one Christ soul. The reason why we see the word behold in the scriptures. And the punchline basically is, like, from Moses to Elijah, John the Baptist, apparently Kurt Cobain, even going back to Adam, we can find this in the scriptures, have a partiality of their soul is a representation of Christ himself. So basically, if we want to know what Jesus was like in his mannerisms, the way he carried himself, the way he ate, you know, that kind of stuff, apparently we'd be able to see at least a shadow of that in the mannerisms of Kurt Cobain. Now, the Lord showed me this revelation, but it wasn't... At the time I got this revelation, I started having a lot of dreams about Kurt Cobain and Elijah. And I didn't begin to find it scripturally until I stumbled upon the book, The Pistis Sophia. Okay, so before we continue, we need to talk about the book, The Pistis Sophia. This is a text that mainstream Christians blow off as Illuminati kind of stuff. And most people actually aren't aware of its truth. But if you can receive the truth in the Nag Hammadi scriptures, you can receive the truth of the Pistis Sophia. This is not a false text. This is a real book. This is the higher law, the spiritual law, the angelic law. This is the Gnosis. And essentially, the Pistis Sophia is a story of how matter came to be, physical matter. It's actually really amazing. So in book 1, chapter 7 of the Pistis Sophia, we actually hear an account from the words of Christ himself, how the soul of Elijah is wrapped up in John the Baptist. And when I read that, I started getting the confirmation and the understanding, the Lord showing me Kurt Cobain and Elijah. And I know the text, how Moses and Adam and John the Baptist are similitudes of Christ. So I was starting to piece this stuff together. So what we're going to do is listen to an excerpt from the Pistis Sophia. I have a read-along version, and we could see how this stuff, what you see on your screen right now, on your slide, the revelation of the Mount of Transfiguration is indeed real. We could see how this could unfold theologically.
It came to pass then, when I had come into the midst of the rulers of the aeons, that I looked down on the world of mankind by commandment of the first mystery. I found Elizabeth, the mother of John the Baptizer, before she had conceived him, And I sowed into her a power which I had received from the little Ayo, the good, who is in the midst, that he might be able to make proclamation before me and make ready my way and baptize with the water of the forgiveness of sins. That power, then, is in the body of John. Moreover, in the place of the soul of the ruler which he appointed to receive, I found the soul of the prophet Elias in the aeons of the sphere, and I took him thence, and took his soul, and brought it to the Virgin of Light. And she gave it over to her receivers. They brought it into the sphere of the rulers, and cast it into the womb of Elizabeth. So the power of the little Io, who is in the midst, and the soul of the prophet Elias, they were bound into the body of John the Baptizer. For this cause, then, were ye in doubt aforetime. I, when I said unto you, John said, I am not the Christ. And ye said unto me, It standeth written in the Scripture, When the Christ shall come, Elias cometh before him, and maketh ready his way. But when ye said this unto me, I said unto you, Elias verily is come, and hath made all things ready, and it stand written, and they have done unto him as they would. And when I knew that ye had not understood that I had discourse with you concerning the soul of Elias, which is bound into John the Baptizer, I answered you in the discourse and openness face to face, If ye like to accept John the Baptizer, he is Elias, of whom I have said that he will come.
Okay, so we could clearly see evidence of this, at least what I call the one Christ soul. I don't have a name for this, but that apparently is found in Kurt Cobain. It's found in Moses, Elijah, John the Baptist, even Christ himself. And basically what I want to show you, we could show this scripturally. Now here we are in the Mormon Book of Moses, chapter 1, verse 6, and it clearly states that Moses is in the similitude of God's only begotten. So if we actually knew what Moses looked like, we would probably see a strong resemblance to Jesus himself. That's what the texts are saying. I'm also going to take you into the first book of Adam and Eve. We see the same thing. Adam, who was made after God's own image and similitude, not just his image as two legs and two arms and that kind of stuff. No, and his similitude. Adam was in a resemblance of Christ himself. So clearly, we could see this theology being scriptural, being sound, and being absolutely relevant and indeed truth. So there you have it. The origin of this soul or this partial soul that seems to be wrapped up in God's people or God's chosen people, it's a mystery. I really don't know, but this is what the Lord has shown me, and clearly, you know, as I've demonstrated, we can find it in the scriptures. So if we want to see what Jesus was like, we could see, you know, a type and shadow of his mannerisms through Kurt Cobain. All right, guys, thank you for tuning in. God bless you. Of course, consult the Holy Spirit for all truth. God bless you.